Now on to All Aboard for a train journey with a difference.
Japan, Samurai, Sony and Shinkansen, the bullet train. A design icon, fast, punctual and safe. For the first time, one is to leave the land of the rising sun for York, home of the National Railway Museum. Tonight, the inside story of this remarkable present from east to west. The world's best-known train comes to the country that invented the railways. 6,000 miles, halfway across the world, a job that'll push British engineers' skill and nerves to the limit.
Very tight. Slow him down, he's going too fast. Trevor, will you get control of this bloody train?
Central Station, Tokyo. The world's fastest train, the Tokaido Express. At peak hours, it leaves every 5 or 10 minutes. The line is run like a commuter service. Yet each train travels 340 miles, linking Tokyo with Osaka, Japan's two biggest towns, as far apart as London and Edinburgh. Journey time, only 3 hours.
And they're still running, and still hardly ever late. The next arrival at York will be a 200 kilometres an hour zero-class Shinkansen. It's a 40-year-old design that's given Britain a lesson in punctuality. And how the design has moved on. These are trains, but not as we know them.
If you were to ask a six-year-old child what trains they know about, they're likely to say Thomas the Tank Engine, Stevenson's Rocket, Mallard, perhaps Flying Scotsman, and the Bullet Train. It's an icon that's changed the world, so it's wholly appropriate that it should be in the National Collection.
It's the morning shift at the central station in Fukuoka, southern terminus of the Shinkansen network. Drivers recite the company mantra, to be safe, to be on time, to be reliable. The route is checked, timing's agreed, there's no room for human error, the system won't allow it. The drivers dress more like airline pilots than railway men. Bullet trains started running in the mid-1960s. Hundreds of millions of pounds were spent building a dedicated fast train-only network. No slow traffic to get in the way. Richard Gibbon is learning to love the bullet train. He's travelling to Fukuoka to oversee the departure of York's new exhibit. It's a unique venture. It'll be the first foreign train to be displayed at York.
What we're seeing here is not so much a relationship between man and the machine, but between the man and the system. This physical checking, every gesture, instead of we would just look at the speedometer, we would look at the indicator. Here there is a physical linking and reporting back. And it's what we can look forward to in Britain.
The Japanese are rightly proud of their bullet trains. Punctuality isn't fiction. Earlier this year, a bullet train was 1 minute late and the driver was hauled off to face an inquiry. And in almost 40 years of running, there hasn't been a fatality in an accident.
I believe that the bullet train represents a whole new change of thinking in railways. What the Japanese have done with the bullet train in the 1960s was to say the next big step is to go for high-speed rail travel
on a dedicated infrastructure.
They went for a different gauge. They went from 3'6" to standard gauge, our gauge, 4'8½". And they put the railway up on stilts through the middle of the city. They went through the mountains, over the hills, and they produced this wonderful great white bird, the bullet train.
This is Fukuoka, population 1.5 million, Japan's seventh biggest city. This is JR West Maintenance Depot on the outskirts of Fukuoka. Richard Gibbon is about to see York's train for the first time, and there are a few problems that need to be sorted out.
On the ship in Britain, that is the thing I have not... I have no problems in Japan. I want to know how the vehicle is going to arrive at Southampton. That is the big problem. I need to explain why this is of concern, because getting a big crane in Southampton strong enough to lift the thing off is not easy in Southampton. So it is important that the Shinkansen is put back together at Southampton. It has to be put back onto its bogies. We're going to need to translate the word bogies.
And that's one translation that needs to be spot on.
Thank you. So everything is brand new. Wow. We never have something so beautiful, because whenever we take things into the museum, they are always at the end of their life.
Yeah.
So this is very special. It is a great pleasure to be here in Japan to see for the first time the bullet train that you have prepared so beautifully for us to have in York. 500,000 people a year, visitors to our museum, will be able to learn about the bullet train, they'll be able to enjoy all your hard work, and they'll be able to understand the story of how the Japanese bullet train has revolutionized high-speed rail travel in the world forever. I think there are certain shapes, both engineering and architectural, that are forever, that are icons. The Dakota, the Spitfire, the E-type Jaguar. All of these shapes that man has created look right. When you look at the Spitfire aircraft, when you look at this, it just looks right and feels right.
But is it the right size? The bullet train will be the biggest exhibit at the museum, a giant amongst giants.
Right, that's working out to 24 meters, 150. So
The design team work out whether the 112-foot-long train and its displays will actually fit into the space that's been provided.
You've still got plenty of access space around the front.
That's right.
You've got your photo opportunity as you come in, and the chance to sort of then pick up the story of these three vehicles later on and look at the story of speed. It's going to be interesting. It's going to look quite impressive.
And also, we need to look at this cover, because if we're going to keep it under wraps, we need to be convinced that cover fits. And I assume someone checked, but I think I'd rather reassure myself that it will fit.
It's the day before the bullet train leaves for England.
I didn't know until I'd spent a lot of time with Japanese people this business about harmony. You don't have disagreements at meetings. You go outside to change the way things are going. The idea that the manager of every department store comes out at 6 o'clock at night to shake hands and bow to the very last customer who leaves his store. I mean, that's unthinkable in Britain. And it's to do with harmony and etiquette, and it's great. The idea that they are striving for harmony in everything is a very attractive condition, and I like it.
But will honour and balance be in perfect harmony as the train leaves for York?
Right, the thing that's worrying me is this bit.
It's the constructive detail.
In which way is it worrying you?
The design team, meanwhile, are still thrashing things out. Back in York, size is important.
A nice, good, clear space around it. So I just want to satisfy myself that it all works.
When we walked the space with Richard Gibbon, he was really keen to stress, this nose doesn't want to come any further this way. This is the real critical issue for him. Mm. Was to keep the whole thing as tight up to this buttress as possible.
At Fukuoka Docks, it's sayonara to this unusual present from east to west, and the Japanese make it a send-off with a difference.
We are very proud to accept this vehicle to take its place in our collection on display at York, which we believe to be the finest railway collection in the world.
私たちは育った沖にですね、こういったものが手にしていただけるなんてことは思ってもなかったんです。ですからですね、私たちは今度はですね、誇りを持って日本人のたくさんで、ツアーを連れてですね、もう一遍行こうじゃないかって言ってですね、日本人のその誇りを持つようにしようと思って、その、なんていうんですかね、誇りを与えてくださったって意味では大変光栄なんだなんですよね。
It's all gone without any hitch. Which
yes, no problem.
How would you expect a Japanese organisation?
I thought at that moment, my goodness me, we've unleashed the ball rolling down the mountain, and it's been launched beautifully, and now it's up to us, up to me, and the team, to get it back safely into the museum.
There is my locomotive in here. This is ridiculous to come all the way around the world to see my own handiwork here.
So where there's a train, You'll always find a train spotter.
I hope he will come back to York and see the new wing. Thank you. Arigato. That's wonderful. That's the highlight of my afternoon. And it's made me homesick.
Thank you.
Okay, that's good. Thanks for doing that. We finally got it underway. There's no going back now. It's going to leave here in a few minutes. I've been very proud. I've been concerned, but I've never been worried about the safety of a thing. I've never been worried about anything to do with the project because it's obviously very well organized. In terms of efficiency and timekeeping, which I very much doubt that we'll be able to keep this up all the way to York, but that's the Japanese way of doing things. So we've got to do the honourable thing by the Japanese. I know that when we come to transfer this thing on rail track, that it's going to be full of problems once we get it onto the railway. I just hope the Japanese aren't there to see us wrestling with the problems, because they've had no problems at all today.
And so the bullet train begins its journey up the Japanese coast. It changes ship and heads out on its 8-week odyssey that will bring it to England. Out of the darkness, the Talisman arrives with its unique cargo, destination York.
Just go through what we're going to do. The two cranes will get in position over this vehicle and just lift it. And then the two road bogies will run out from underneath, and the lorry will back underneath with the bogies into position and lower down.
It's a delicate operation, even more so under the watchful eye of Japanese engineers.
Hold it there.
It's the first time the National Railway Museum has ever acquired a vehicle not built in Britain or used in Britain. But its significance in the history of the railways of the world and their development is so fundamental that we felt the opportunity to bring one to York should not be passed up. Are you ready? A one, two, three. Gone. Japanese steel! I'm trying to go on there. Is that one?
Go on. Smack it on the knife, that's
it. We feel a bit, sad to part with this vehicle, because we cherish it very much. And I'd like to send a daughter as a wedding to other country.
And now
6:24, the travel from Sally Postman.
M1 northbound still slowing up 28 to 29, following this Japanese train, the bullet train, which is heading up towards York, and it was parked up at junction 29 on a lay-by, and people are all slowing down to have a look.
It's the night of the move into the museum, and the first of many problems. Richard needs 8 bolts to make the Shinkansen safe to move, but thousands have been sent, and the instructions are in Japanese. Moving steam engines around the museum proves to be an easier task. The bullet train is so big and wide that more space has to be cleared.
Little Talus Lin here is in the way, which is a great shame. So what we have to do is to lay temporary track and pull it back and make the angle greater on the temporary track. It's actually a yard wider than our rolling stock. 3 inches, 6.5 ton.
It's midnight, and Richard is anxious. The only way to get the bullet train into the museum is by rail, and that means putting it on the East Coast main line, which has been closed for 7 hours.
That's it, we'll get it there.
To make matters worse, the couplings don't quite fit.
We're not lined up because the position of the locomotive is very critical. If we don't keep these plates square, we're shafted. Just quarter of an inch, Graham.
Stop!
Whoa. Stop! Just get hitting it hard.
Oh, no! You can't give up. Stop!
Whoa!
The bullet train is the widest train ever to travel on Britain's railways. Almost 30 signs and signals have had to be moved, but one has been missed.
It's very interesting because I myself have walked this route and I've missed this as much as anybody else has. We're missing the things that are very low and very high, and we're just looking around the area at platform level. But the race against the clock is that we're all tired and we've got people waiting at the museum to get the thing berthed in its correct position, and the museum does open tomorrow morning, and this thing has got to be in, sheeted, invisible, and the museum's got to be put back together and tidy.
It's dawn, and the bullet train is within spitting distance of the museum, but there's yet another hitch. The train is so big it could hit a concrete curbway. Well, to get snagged here would be a disaster.
Let's just keep our judgment. Slow him down.
Slow him down, slow him down.
Slow him down, he's going too fast.
Take it easy about the gantry.
Slowly, Trev. Very, very slow. We know what we don't want any heroics and clever bits. He's tightening. Slow him down. Trevor, will you get control of this bloody train?
Stop him. Stop.
Right, just nice and slow, please.
Take it easy about the gantry.
Slowly, Trev. Ray doesn't do slow, does he?
Stop him. Stop him.
Now, the chances are that when the wheel goes up on the wood, it's going to go all over the place. But let's go through. Right, ready? What we want is you, Malcolm, very carefully steering that other piece of wood, but getting out of the way. Malcolm, be very careful. Just leave it. Don't try anything clever. I'll just give him another inch of clearance. That's lovely. OK, now he can take a run at it. Yeah, bring him on. Yes, I know, it's done the same here. Just let it go. Okay, go. We're damn nearly there now.
Hello? Stop it! Trip it off, Liddy. Come on, that's why.
It just about squeezes in. 6,000 miles gone, just 100 feet to go.
Round anyway. So.
Even the turntable is a tight fit. Clearance is in inches.
You're on. Well done, boys.
Are you clear?
Yeah, I'm clear.
A new home, a Japanese takeaway, and how fitting that the bullet train sits next to Mallard and Eurostar, all groundbreakers in their day.
That's it. Well done. Very good.
Went very well. One or two little scrapes, eh?
What scrapes? I didn't see anything. See you, Greg.
It is the hardest thing that we've done because it's so close. Yeah. And we had no idea how close it was going to be there.
All the things that could have gone wrong, nothing did. And people will just come in and they'll say, oh,
yes, they were.
But you see, one of the common questions about the Chinese engine that everybody asks is, how did it get here? I think there will be people will ask the question, how did it get here?
So, the moment of unveiling has arrived, and everything has to be right.
Are you ready with your guys, Derek? We need six of us.
Oh, we've got six in there.
We have. We'll use the cameraman. Where's David? You'll know if it's come off clean because it'll fall like a waterfall. As soon as it comes over, it'll tumble like a waterfall.
It's only one left into it.
Go for it!
It's the bullet that came to Britain. York's very own Oriental Express.
Britain's railways have been through a dreadful patch, and they need some sort of injection of energy to take us out of this doldrums that we're in. When we show people what the Japanese have achieved, perhaps the thinking will change towards a totally reliable, totally safe railway, which is what everyone in Britain wants.
Kanpai.